In this session, we are going to discuss one example on query processing. This video is a continuation of the previous video. Please watch that one, then you can get the total context. Now, as an example, let us consider this particular SQL statement. The statement is written as select salary from instructor where salary less than 75,000. So now let us suppose this is a particular query is getting executed on a table named as instructor, and this instructor table is having multiple different attributes. Let us suppose it is having say 40 different attributes are there, but this particular query will fetch only data from the salary table and for those salaries which are lesser than 75,000. Let us suppose that this particular instructor table is having 5,000 records or tuples. Out of them, only say 400 tuples are there where the salary value is less than 75,000. So 5,000 tuples in total and only 400 tuples are satisfying this particular condition, that is salary less than 75,000. So in that case, what will happen? We know that this particular query will be parsed at first. It will check whether it is grammatically okay or not, and then the respective relational algebraic form will be produced. So relational algebra expression will be produced. Okay. Now, this is the first relational algebraic form for this particular SQL statement. So that is sigma salary less than 75,000 and pi salary working on this instructor. And I am writing the other version of the same algebraic form, relational algebra expression, where pi salary is coming outside and internally I am operating with sigma salary less than 75,000 and it will be operating on this particular instructor. Okay, so these are the two queries that are there. Now see, as I mentioned earlier, that this particular table instructor is having 5,000 records or tuples. So now when you are applying this pi salary on this instructor, so only the salary attribute is getting selected, that's true, but it is dealing with all 5,000 values, all 5,000 values, one value for each record. So all 5,000 values are getting selected, and then on that 5,000 values it is applying this particular sigma or select operation where salary less than 75,000, so the result will be obtained. This particular SQL relational algebra expression will produce the same output, that we know, but here this pi salary less than 75,000 operating on instructor, this particular query will generate or will select only 400 records, 400 tuples or tuples. So 400 records will be selected, and then out of them it will be doing this particular projection operation. So salary will be selected and respective 400 values will be selected. So here this outer query is operating on 5,000 records, but this in this particular relational algebra expression, the outer operator, that is our pi, that is a projection, is dealing with 400 such values or 400 records. So you see the complexity of these two relational algebra expression, in spite of the fact that they are going to produce the same output, but the complexity values will be different. And this is the main notion behind this query processing, so that they can reduce this complexity. To reduce this particular complexity of query processing, not only considering that how much tuples we are dealing during the runtime in the memory, that is not always the main aspect. We'll be also considering the position of this particular table, where these tables are got distributed. Because query processing will be too much complicated when you will be going for the distributed environment. Now see, not only this data, not only considering that how many records we are having in the runtime, we should also consider different security measures to make the query perfect before getting executed and optimized before getting executed. So here one tree structure will keep our conception, will make our conception clear. So query processing strategy. So here we are having the query modification, response time consideration, that is also very important, that after issuing the query, how much time it is taking to give me the output. And then data characteristics consideration, that means what kind of data you are going to deal with. So there is a data characteristics considerations at the third point. Under this, we are having equivalent form query substitution. That means one query can be substituted by the other queries, but both will produce the same output at the end. So query decomposition, the query will be decomposed into multiple subqueries, and we know that nested subqueries will have the complexity lesser than the subquery without query written without any subqueries. And query on view to base relations, that means through this particular view we are getting a subset of the database. So this particular query is also considered in this particular aspect. This query processing is considered in this particular aspect. And enforced security, I told you earlier that whether this particular query is execution is violating any kind of security measures or not. Data characteristics considerations will having three aspects are there. The first one is the size of the records, that means with how many bytes of data you are dealing with per record. So that is also a very important aspect. So now we are having the presence of access aids. So what are the different access aids you are using to access that particular data from the database? What are the internal data structures they are using? Are they using B plus tree? Are they using ISAM, index sequential access method? Are they using any clustered architecture, clustered record architecture? And then size of the intermediate results. So what are the in the case of subqueries, we know that intermediate results will be produced, on that the outer query will be working. So here also this intermediate result is having a size of 5000 records. Here this intermediate result is producing 400 records. So this is the point size of intermediate results. So keeping all these aspects, a query will be processed and optimized prior to being executed by the system. Thanks for watching this video.